According to President Kennedy, the United States is going to make an all-out effort to put a man on the moon within 10 years. But I have a few friends, they belong to my bowling club, and they don't want to wait that long. They're getting impatient. As a matter of fact, they've just built their own homemade rocket ship. And 2 weeks from now, they'll be blasting off for the moon from a parking lot somewhere on Flatbush Avenue. Can you imagine what this trip is going to be like? Men will be blasting off in a couple of minutes. Here's your final instructions. Hackett, you light the match. Strauss, you're in charge of communications. Keep contact with Earth at all times. Make sure you have enough extension cord. Morelli, you're in charge of oxygen supply. Don't waste any. It's precious stuff. But when you see us go like this,
give us a little more.
Cartwright, you're in charge of crayons. All right, men, we're also honored to have with us on this trip the famous American rocket scientist, Dr. Adams. Doctor, would you like to explain gravity and weightlessness to the men? Well, you see, the law of gravity... Why the German accent, Doctor? That's the only way I could get the job. Where was I? Gravity, yes. When you sit under an apple tree, when an apple falls and it hits you right on the head, I see, that's gravity. No, you see nothing. That's pain, boy. That hurts. But when you sit on an apple tree, an apple falls, it doesn't hit you on the head. That's weightlessness? No, that's luck. Another foot to the right, you would have got right on the head again. Well, thank you very much, Doctor. All right, men, prepare for countdown. 10, 9, 8. Hackett, when you light that match, get back to the ship in a hurry. You know, whoosh. 7, 6, 5. No use raising your hand, Morelli. You can't leave the room. 3, 2, whoosh. And off they go, through the stratosphere, through the mesosphere, through the ionosphere, through the Lincoln Tunnel, and out of space. Meanwhile, inside the ship, Doc, is it everything you expected? Boy, wow, what a sight. Boy, that's a beautiful view. You can see the whole coastline, Doctor? No, I can see the whole floor. I'm floating up here on the ceiling, and that's a gorgeous floor. I've never seen a floor from up here before. That's worth the whole trip alone. All right, men, prepare for landing. Stop too fast, B. Hackett? No, I always wear my pants around my ankles like this. All right, men, we've made it. We've landed on the moon.
Captain.
Yeah, what is it, Doc? There's something very strange coming toward the ship. What does it look like, Doc? Well, a head, 2 legs, 2 arms, and a body. What's so strange about that? They're all walking separately. Fantastic! There is life on the moon. Morelli, get out there and talk to them. What makes you think they talk Italian, Captain? Very funny. I'll talk to them myself. Strauss, get all this down on the tape recorder. How? White man come in peace. June moon, spoon. Chop. What'd he say, Doc? Never mind what he said. I'm trying to figure out what you said. Wait a minute, I think I got it. Strauss, play that back. Of course, that's 78 RPM. Now play it back at 33 and a third. All right, now bring it up to 45. Double your pleasure, double your fun. What do you make of it, Doc? Very simple. They talk television. Write that down, Strauss. He said they get all our TV programs up here, only they get them a day sooner. Amazing. All right, you moon people. We are here on a purely scientific expedition. We want to dig up and bring back samples of the moon's surface. Is that all right with you? He said you can have a 1/4 pound of cheddar, a 1/2 pound of mozzarella. And all the Limburg you can carry. Very funny. Old cheese jokes. He said he heard that joke tomorrow night on the Bob Hope Show. All right, let's get down to brass tacks. Since we are the first from Earth to reach the moon, we want to know where we can put the flag. He said you can run it up on the flagpole, sir. Flagpole? What flagpole? The one in front of the Russian tea room, sir.